posted last Friday, and anybody that wanted to see it would have had access to it.
Prior to the.
Prior to it being passed.
Right, exactly. Yes, Frank.
Frank Schimmel, there at 1030 Allentown Road.
I think the way you're presenting it is the right way to do it, and I think you still have to have a reason for people who want to come to these meetings.
Yes.
And, you know, I was the one that asked you to table it, and I thank you for that. Jay, I thank you for the sort of having it both ways, and, you know, thank you very much.
Okay. Any other comments? Okay, I will put up a motion. I will make the motion to have the treasurer's report and payment of bills list put on the consent agenda, which will be available on Friday before the meeting, and give you time to look at it, and then it will also be available in the minutes after the meeting, and it will also, the treasurer's report will still be read in the meeting, so.
I'll second that motion.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye, okay, thank you. New business.
You're still in old business?
Oh, old business, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I have an old business item to bring up.
Yeah.
And that is the subject of Airbnbs that we've been discussing for months. I have reached out to some other supervisors in other townships, and I'm in the process of getting some paperwork that is related to what they do up in the Poconos in Pike County. When I get that information, I'm going to forward it to Greg so that he can share with the other two supervisors regarding how they handle these things. Now, we've heard arguments, and I've had a conversation with some citizens just last week about the issues up on Tower Road. Tower Road is a unique area because it's one way in and only one way out. So you have to consider the residents that live up there. And those of you residents that are sitting in this room that have expressed your concern and complaints to me, I'm on your side. And I want to make sure when we make a decision that we make the right decision. But we need to protect the citizens of this township so that they can enjoy their home as well as everybody else enjoys theirs. So I'm asking for the board to have a little patience here in the process of what we go through until we come to a decision on what we do. I do think that we need to do something. It was stated last month that that someone doesn't want us to create a knee-jerk reaction. This is anything but a knee-jerk reaction. I've been on the police commission for almost the entire time I've been a supervisor, and I know the issues that the police have dealt with up there on Tower Road. I know the parking in other people's driveways. I know the blocking of the roads. These things we have to work out because we're all neighbors, and yes, Airbnbs can be nice, but there are places for them that they have to abide by. So that's my concern from old business.
Yeah, great, and I agree with you completely. We need to get this right for the sign. Yeah. And the information you're getting is going to help a lot.
Okay.
Thank you. Any other comments? Yes, sir.
I'm Paul Chapman. I live on 302 Tower Road. I was just going to bring that up tonight to see if you were looking into other things or if it was finalized, and it's not just about Tower Road, but it is in my backyard and a lot of our places, and there's a place for it. Bedminster Township, the thing Jay's doing, it's been to the Pennsylvania Supreme Court, it's a residential area. There's a lot more stuff out there, and other townships have already passed this, and we need to do something here, whether you like it or you don't like it. We need to control this, but down the line, big hotels, when you find out about the situation up in Pike County, they were people living in New York that just bought a place, never lived there, and opened it up, and it was just strictly business, just like is going to happen in 20, 50 years if townships and places don't get a handle on it. It's a business. It's not making a little extra money. And it doesn't belong, it sure doesn't belong where we're at.
Thanks for your comments. Any other comments? Okay, we'll move on. Thank you. Is there any other old business? All right. Seeing none, move on to new business. Does anyone have new business?
I don't have any business.
Okay.
We have two items that you may want to consider. The first item is the board wants to make a donation to the Park and Rec on behalf of John Mann.
I'm all for that. I think we should. His colleague said in lieu of flowers, please make a donation to the Park and Rec.
and you have a second item. The board needs to make a motion if they want to appeal the FERC decision for the adopted.
I believe we do. Can I get a motion?
We almost have one.
Yeah, we do, absolutely do. So you're making a motion, Jay?
Let's see.
Oh.
I'll make the motion.
Oh, you're making a motion, okay. And second?
Second.
Okay. And all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. We all agree with that. This has to be. Okay, is there any other new business?
I have none.
Seeing none, we'll move on to public comment. The floor is open. You get 2.5 minutes, and we can start with Mr. Paul.
I'm very happy. My name's Cliff Cole, 2440 Street Pressure. I'm very happy to see that you've decided to appeal the FERC's decision. In case public is not aware, FERC has given the go-ahead to the Adelphia Quakertown compressor station with contingencies that they also get all the necessary approvals from the DEP, for instance. But I just want to read what one of the dissenting commissioner of the FERC wrote. It was a 2-1 decision, and to me, this is basically a blueprint for the appeal. This was Richard Glick. Today's order is not the product of reasoned decision making. Its analysis of the project's contribution to climate change is shoddy, and its conclusion that the project will not have any significant environmental impact is illogical. After all, the commission itself acknowledges that the project will contribute to climate change, but refuses to consider whether the contribution might be significant before proclaiming the project will have no significant environmental impact. So long as this is the case, the record simply cannot support the commission's conclusion that there will be no significant environmental impact. Simply put, the commission's analysis of the project consequences for climate change does not represent the hard look that the new law requires. Richard Glick.
Thank you, Mr. Cole.
I'd also like to comment that the Delaware Riverkeeper is also going to appeal this decision, and they are working with the Clean Air Council. We have had people from the Clean Air Council up here before, but if residents, and especially the supervisors, could join Delaware Riverkeepers, that would be a great thing. It gives them more standing in our community. If you need more information about that, it's free to join, and of course, they are looking for money too.
Thank you, Mr. Cole. Any other public comments? Yes. Frank. Frank, you were first.
About a year and a half ago, we discussed the clean out of septic systems. It's on a 3-year plan, and I asked the question if it was possible to change that, because you have senior citizens now where the families have already left them, and you got 1, 2 people living in the house, and they're not putting out as much septic as an average family. And I don't know whether that's covered by state law that you can't change it, or
the DEP likes to see 3 years if they feel that things are going really well. Sometimes I've seen in certain areas where the soil types are excellent and reducing that requirement. It would have to be an amendment to the 537 plan, or at least an amendment to the on-lot disposal system ordinance. And it would require Steve and Greg communicating with DEP and getting their permission. It's not something that you would want to do unilaterally for fear of running afoul of DEP.
Okay. So it's going to be status quo?
I didn't know that that's what I said.
No, that's not what you said. Well, you know, we don't want to go through with it. You just said it's not something we may want to do.
No, I said unilaterally, but not without input from DEP and approval from DEP. Whether whether or not Greg or Steve reaches out to DEP to see if that's acceptable to them. That's the policy decision.
Because I think a couple other townships have approached that or looking at it the same way, and how I feel about it. And I don't know whether there are ever any changes made to it.
I've seen ordinances that require emptying every 2 years be extended to 3 years with DEP's approval. I've never seen 3 years before.
Thank you.
I give Mike 10 minutes left.
If
anybody else wants to use
it. Yeah, 4 or 7:15
Valley
Road.
You've got 4 and a half.
this will take less time than it took people to walk up there. You mentioned for recording meetings, you're going to record the supervisors meeting and the planning commission meeting.
Yes.
Can I ask that you also have a zoning hearing board meeting today?
I don't know if we can. Is there any law against it? We don't actually run the zoning hearing board.
I don't see any. The zoning hearing board would have to make their own decision.
Right.
But there's nothing for them.
If the zoning hearing board would allow us to, then we could do that, yes. Yes.
Thank you.
Back to the board.
I was just wondering, is that statewide with that septic stuff in every county in this whole state, or is every township set it up?
Your name and address, please.
Paul Chatton, 302
Colorado. Hi. Every township in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania has to have a Act 537 sewage disposal plan approved by PennDOT. I don't represent municipalities all over the state. I represent municipalities more in Bucks and Montgomery County, where the soil types are clay mostly, and I have not seen DEP approve anything less frequent than 3 years for MCA.
Thank you. Any other public comments? Yes, Ivy.
Ivy Sharmer, 1805 Ridge Road. I would just like to ask the supervisors to consider the Penridge Community Center, which is our senior center for West Rockhill, your annual donation. I do not have the pamphlets for you or the budget to give you. We are running behind after their disastrous 3 month close down because of the flood. We then turned around and had a management change. And so we are behind, but hopefully by February I will have
okay.
the pamphlet and budget to give you, but I would like you to just keep in mind to consider the annual donation we make to the senior center.
We'll do that. Thank you. Are there any other public comments? Yes.
Yeah, Fred Dice Road, 201 Lonely Road. I'd like to say just a little bit about John Mann. John was a good friend, and unfortunately died by the town, and didn't get a chance to go to the service, but did have a chance to talk a lot about him. And I guess John, I don't know anybody that didn't like John Mann. He just had that type of personality. And I know my wife and I talked about him, well, several times. And I guess my feeling is that John's legacy will probably be that he never told a good joke. And I don't know how many times John would come up to me and say, Greg, you want to hear a good joke? And I'd say, John, I've heard a lot of your jokes, and you don't know good jokes. But anyhow, I guess I'd just like to say, wherever John goes, because up or down, I hope he gets, better material and maybe a better presentation so that he don't treat the people where he is the way he treated me all these years.
At the funeral, John's children mentioned that John was always known as Happy Pappy. So, John always had a smile on their face, and that family just loved him and so did everybody around. Thank you, Fred. Is there any other public comments? Yes, Dave.
Dave Rice, Timothy Augustine. Just curious, if we were talking about reporting parking right meetings, we were talking about all the other meetings.
Yeah.
No, we didn't.
Okay. I think so.
We had just landed on that. No.
Okay.
Not unless you specifically come to us and say you want to do it.
They're exciting. I mean, if we...
They are exciting, but...
It's
like the conservation committee. There's things that could go on in there which a lot of people wouldn't understand because you're just kicking ideas around and stuff like that. When you get things like the Planning Commission, I mean, that comes down to Bill mainly because, believe it or not, that camera's secure. You can't just walk in this room and turn it on. So we make sure that whoever turns that on has the authority to turn it on. And and I don't think there's anybody on the partner right that has that authority right now. Okay, any other public comments? Yes.
I have a question.
Name and address, please.
Oh, I'm sorry. Sue Farrell on West Rockhill, West Rockhill Township, Bart Road.
Yes.
You talked about, I think it was a committee, and you said if you didn't know if they were going to allow the meetings to be recorded.
It wasn't a committee. It was a zoning hearing board. The zoning hearing board is by law an independent body.
Is it public?
It's public.
Okay.
There's a difference between you walking in and recording and us walking in and recording.
I understand that, but if it's a public meeting.
It is a public meeting, and if you'd like to come in and record the meetings, but they are an independent body, and the Board of Supervisors can't make decisions for them as to whether they want their meetings recorded at the township level.
It's not whether or not they want to. I mean, if the public wants it to, wouldn't that be?
If the public wants it to, as you do, they're welcome to come in and take them.
But they would not have a responsibility to provide. Do they meet here?
Yes, they do.
Okay, so we have the equipment, it's a public meeting, and if the public would like to see it, what would their objection be?
Well, you'll have to ask them that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Any other public comments? Seeing none, I'll call for adjournment.
I'll make a motion for adjournment.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you all for coming out. I also want to mention, nobody else has a turnout like this.